In this example, the figure shows a large horizontal coil of radius R, which is carrying a current I, and another small coil of radius small r, which is very less compared to the radius of this larger coil, which is also carrying a current small I, and total N turns is placed at the center with its plane at an angle theta from the axis of this larger coil. And we are required to find the torque experienced by the smaller coil in this situation. Here we can see that the smaller coil is placed in the magnetic induction of the larger coil at some angle theta to the direction of magnetic induction. So here we can see it will experience some magnetic torque. In that situation, if we calculate the magnetic moment of a smaller coil, we know that the magnetic moment M can be given as the product of current multiplied by the area enclosed by the smaller coil, which is pi r square multiplied by the total number of turns. So it will be Ni pi r square, which is the magnetic moment. And the direction of this magnetic moment, depending on the direction of small I, we can see it will exist in this direction. This is the direction of M vector, which is always normal to the plane of coil. And the direction is given by right hand thumb rule by circulating fingers along the direction of current. Now, if we calculate the magnetic induction due to large coil at its center, then this large coil will produce a magnetic induction B, which can be given as mu naught I by 2R. Which we know this is the magnetic induction due to a circular coil at its center. And here we can see the direction of this magnetic induction will be in this direction, that is B vector in upward direction here according to the direction of flowing current in the large coil. Now in this situation, if we see the angle between magnetic induction vector and magnetic moment vector, it is pi by 2 plus theta. So theta between B vector and M vector, we can write this equals to pi by 2 plus theta. And here we can directly write the torque on a smaller coil. Here we can see it is given as torque is equals to M cross B. So in this situation, direction of M cross B, we can calculate again by right hand thumb rule, it will be in outward direction. So the torque vector will be acting in outward direction, or the smaller coil will experience an anti-clockwise torque. The magnitude of torque we can write as MB sine of the angle between the two, which is pi by 2 plus theta. So in this situation, in magnitude, we can write the value of torque is Ni pi r square multiplied by the magnetic induction, which is given as mu naught I by 2R. Multiplied by, for magnitude, we take cos theta. So the result of net torque on the smaller coil can be written as mu naught I capital I n pi r square by 2 r cos theta. That will be the answer to this problem.